I actually get a unboxing here. This is the only thing I've done is opened it so that the addresses aren't being shown. I got a letter from Jim. Jim, I'm not going to read that on camera, obviously. Thank you so much. I will read that after. But this is a true unboxing. I have no idea what's in here. Well, I do have some idea, because Jim and I were talking about trading some Dungeons & Dragons miniatures. And here they are. Now, I have no idea who these guys are. That's a mounted paladin. But I have come up with a list, so I know which ones I need and which ones I don't need. The gelatinous cube. I've heard so much, even the Big Bang Theory has alluded to this. Somebody give me the background to this. That is extremely cool. I've heard so much about it, and I know it's rare by the star, and I know I don't have it. Like Christmas. Ooh, look at this guy. Huge gold dragon, no kidding. And I'm not going to go through every single miniature, but these are a bunch more miniatures that I do not have in my collection. So Jim, I'll have to go through and see. I know you sort of gave me a want list as well. And I will go through that and see what we can do for a trade. Now, Jim was also gracious enough. As soon as he saw that I was doing figures for Ben from Ben's RPG pile, he wanted to send a couple of his own that I could forward to Ben. And one thing he mentioned is if I want to touch them up or repaint them. And as soon as he said that, I thought, absolutely not. Especially a gift. I know I've had a few figures painted by other people, and I've never touched them up. Just because that was their work and effort, and I don't care if they're a better or worse painter than me. I really appreciated the gesture. And so this one is a rat catcher, and I can't remember what he said this guy is. There's no marking on the bottom. Ben will probably be able to recognize them. So Ben, these are going in the case, and I'm going to ship them off today. So you should get your figures in 5 to 8 days. As soon as I'm done uploading this video, I'll be sending it off to you. And here's some other smaller miniatures, D&D miniatures that I didn't have, and the cards. Any other guys are interested in trading, please let me know, because I'm still trying to complete my set. So very cool. Now, part of the trade was I asked Jim. I said, do you have a figure that you're either dreading to paint or want somebody else to paint it? And the first thing that came to his mind was this dragon, Witch King on Black Dragon. And I said, well, I haven't painted a dragon yet, so I'm more than happy to paint this up as part of the trade or whatever we sort out. So, well, it's never been put together. And he said it was part plastic, part metal kit. I thought the body was going to be metal, to be honest. Jim, you didn't say you didn't say you were sending that. I don't have that one. Thank you so much. That's a complete surprise in the box. I thought the box was a little heavy when I picked it up, but I didn't realize you were sending me a codex. So, I'm just, I'll show you in a second. I'm painting one more figure for me, and then I'm going to move on to this. Now, one thing Jim and I talked about, we didn't know, were we going to do the black color scheme, or he looked at the dragon and thought it may be more of a sea dragon, so where I'd go with the blues. So, I'm going to have a look at it and see what I feel, or my opinion, then Jim and I will be discussing, and I'm going to start working on this. I'm actually looking forward to this. It's a large model, but I've never painted a dragon. So a few more things. I'll just show you what I'm working on, and then read the letter from Jim. And Ben, your box will be in the mail, and arrive in about 5 to 8 days. Be right back. Jim, I read your letter. Thank you so much for your generosity, your kindness. You know, I've sent this to you before in a PM, and you know, the world would be a much better place if we had more guys like you. So thank you so much. I really am looking forward to painting the dragon. Just guys, on a side note of painting, you know, I've painted about 5,000 points in orcs and 5,000 points in evil sons, and in the last couple of weeks, I really haven't painted much of my own. I've painted three of the chaos dwarves, and then I moved on to Ben's townsfolk, and now I'm on to Jim's dragon. The only thing I've done in between for me has been this, and this was actually, I believe it was a gift from Clarkson, which I think is one of the funniest sculpts from 40K that I've seen. Is two grots, one staring down a barrel, and the other one with his finger on the trigger. So that I'm working on, and I'm almost done it. So as soon as that's done, I'm moving on the dragon. But my point in saying is that in the last, let's say, 4 weeks, I haven't painted anything for myself, but I haven't found it to be work at all, because I wanted to do it. Just a suggestion out to you guys, if you have the means and you know somebody on YouTube that's, you know, done a video that you really appreciated, or answered a question for you by a PM, like went out of their way and spent even a few minutes, if you have the means, go on their channel, figure out what they're painting or doing, and do something nice for them. Because I'm telling you, it comes back tenfold. You might get taken once out of the 10 people or 20 people that you do it for, but the paybacks are always 10 times what you put into it. Whether it's just your own personal feelings, or like Jim today sending me the codex that I didn't even know was coming. So just food for thought. Not to get too sappy on you guys, but share the love. Anyhow, this is what I'm working on. The next figure is going to be the dragon, and one reason why the 40K has been stalled is because I'm waiting for Vallejo Model Air to come in. I bought the metallic set, and I want to move on to Necrons, but I'm waiting for that airbrush paint to come in, and it still hasn't come in yet. So this is perfect timing to get some of my, I don't want to say goodwill projects out, but that's kind of what they are, because I don't want any money for them. It's just something I wanted to do for people. Cheers, guys. Please go and see Jedi Jim's. I think his actual name is Jedi Jim 242. If you're a sub of mine and haven't seen his channel, please go and do so. He's listed some old school figures and stuff. He's been in the hobby for quite a few years. I know he won't mind me saying that. but go and have a look at his channel. And then secondly, Ben's RPG Pile 2. Have a look there. I think he's going to do an unboxing once he gets the figures, so I'm really interested in seeing that. The other thing, I also, turning into a ramble, Ben has sent me a package as well as a token or thank you for what I've done for him, and I wasn't even expecting it. So I am so interested to see what he's sending, and I'll be doing an unboxing when it arrives. So, cheers, guys. Bye-bye.